Good morning, my dear students. So we are now graphs. What is graph? So graph is a collection of vertices and arcs, or collection of nodes and edges. So yesterday we discussed graph and graph terminologies. Already we learned it yesterday class. Yes or no? Then. So this is an example for graph, am I right? So example, the following graph is how many vertices? 5 vertices. Then how many edges? Total how many edges? 7 edges. Clear all of you? How many edges? 7 edges. Okay, then the next one. So graph terminologies, these are all the terminologies. What is vertex? So individual data element of a graph is called as vertex. Vertex is also known as node. So in above example, graph A, B, C, D, E, these are all the vertices. Am I right or not? Are nodes. Clear? So then edges, A to B, then there is a link between two nodes, that is called an edge. Clear? A link between two nodes, that is called an edge. Am I right? So how many edges are here? Then A comma B one edge, A comma C another edge, A comma D another edge. Next, starting with B comma D one edge, C comma D another edge, BE another edge, then ED another edge. Total how many edges? 7 edges. Clear all of you? In this example, 7 edges are there. So 5 nodes are there. Clear all of you? Then the next one is, so edges. So edges are 3 types. How many types of edges? There are 3 types of edges. The first one is undirected edge. This is an example for undirected edge. So in the undirected edge, an undirected edge is a bidirectional edge. Bidirectional means your data transfer from A to B and A to E, B to A. Clear? From A to B and B to A. Clear all of it? That is called bidirectional. Both directions, sending and receiving. So with the help of single link. Clear? Single edge. If there is undirected edge between vertices A and B, then edge AB is equal to edge BA. Clear all of you? Next one, directed edge. Using directed edge, we can transfer the data from only one side. Okay, only one side, which is the direction flow. That's the direction only the data will flow. So a directed edge is undirectional edge. So unidirectional edge. A directed edge is unidirectional edge. If there is a directed edge between vertices A and B, then edge A and B is not equal to B and A. Clear all of you? Then weighted edge. A weighted edge is a edge with value on it. That is called weight or cost. That is also known as cost. Clear? These three are the three kinds of edges. The first one is, how many types of edges? 3 types. The first one is undirected edge. Second one is directed edge. And third one is weighted edge. So undirected graph, shear graphs, undirected graph, directed graph, and mixed graphs. There are 3 types of graphs. The first one is undirected graph, second one is directed graph, and third one is mixed graph. Clear? Undirected graph, then there is no direction. All the edges are undirected. Clear? A graph with only undirected edges is said to be undirected graph. A graph with only undirected edges, then there is no directed edges. Clear? Only undirected. A graph have only undirected edges. That is called undirected graph. Next one is directed graph. So in this example, this is undirected graph. Then there is no direction. Clear? These are all the bidirectional edges. That's why this is called undirected graph. So then the next one is directed graph. A graph with only directed edges is said to be directed graph. So this is the directed graph. These are all the edges are all directions. Clear? This type of graphs are called directed graph. Then the third one is mixed graph. Third one is mixed graph. Mixed graph. A graph with both undirected and directed edges is said to be mixed graph. Clear? End vertices are end points. 2 vertices joined by edges are called end vertices. Of that edge origin. If your edge is directed, its first endpoint is said to be the origin of it. If your edge is directed, its first endpoint is said to be the origin of it. Destination, if the edge is directed, its first endpoint is said to be the origin of the other endpoint. Okay, namma already we learned which is edge point, which is origin, okay, which is endpoint. Source and destination. Source is an origin, then the destination is an endpoint. Clear, all of you? So then the next one is adjacent. So A and B are the adjacents of the graph. Incident, edge is said to be incident on a vertex if the vertex is one of the endpoints of that edge, that is called incident. Outgoing edge and incoming edge, then which is the data flow from A to B. So then A is an outgoing edge, then B is an incoming edge. Clear? Incoming edge. So A to B, then there is a direction. So then simply A transfer the data, that is A output transfer from A to B. B is receiving, that's why B is an incoming edge, A is an outgoing edge. Clear? So which is the receiving input, that is called incoming edge, which is sending output, that is called outgoing edge. Degree, so a node, for example, in this tree, A, what are the degrees of A? How many degrees of A? Then 3, 1, 2, 3, clear? Then how many degrees of B? 1, 2, 3. How many degrees of D? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, clear? So how many edges are connected to the node? That is called degree. Clear, all of you? Then the next one is in degree and out degree. Clear? So how many incomings, how many outgoings? Incomings are called in degree, outgoings are called out degree. Clear? Next one is parallel edges or multiple edges. So what are the parallel edges and what are the multiple edges? Self loops. So a loop, a node sending information to itself only, that is called self loop. Simple graph. A graph is said to be simple if there are no parallel and self loop edges. Path. A path is a sequence of alternate vertices and edges. Clear? So then alternate edges. So in this example, so these are the examples of, oh, this is a graph. This is a directed graph or diagraph. So this is an undirected graph. This is an undirected graph. This is an undirected graph. Clear. Then there is no direction. No directions. Clear, all of you? So then undirected graph. Next one is complete graph. Complete graph. Each node connecting to each other in this graph. So that is called complete graph. Here, next one is, so this is the complete directed graph. This is the complete undirected graph. Clear? So this is the weighted graph. Each edge have a cost, that is called 8. So F to E, this is the weight of this F to E is 9. E to D, this is the weight of this E to D link or edge, that is called 6. This is the 15, this is 17. Okay, this is called a weighted graph. Clear, all of you? And next one is degree of the vertices, vertex. A degree equal to 3, then D degree equal to 3, E degree equal to 3. Yes, you see degree equal to 3. These are the degrees of graph. Okay, all of you? So this is the yesterday portion. Clear? This is the yesterday completed topic. So then today, graph representations. Today topic is graph representations. We want to learn graph representations. Graph representations. Here, graph representations. So graph data structure is represented using following representations. So there are three types of graph representation. The first one is adjacent matrix, and the second one is adjacency matrix. Second one is incidence matrix. Third one is adjacency list. Clear? Adjacency matrix. In this representation, the graph is represented using a matrix of size total number of vertices by a total number of vertices. That means a graph with 4 vertices is represented using a matrix of size 4x4. So in this matrix, both rows and columns represent vertices. This matrix is filled with either 1 or 0 here. Here 1 represents that there is an edge from row vertex to column vertex, and 0 represents that there is no edge from row vertex to column vertex. Clear? This is an example for adjacency matrix. This is an example for adjacency matrix. So how many edges are there? So 5 edges. Here 5 by 5 matrix. We will get 5 by 5 matrix. How many edges are there? 5. So simply 5 rows and 5 columns. If there are 4 edges, 4 by 4 matrix. If there are 3 edges, 3 by 3 matrix. If there are 6 edges, 6 by 6 matrix. Simply here in this example, the graph have how many nodes? 5 nodes, 5 vertices. So then we will get adjacency matrix. So 5 by 5 matrix. Clear? 5 by 5 matrix. Here A, B, C, D, E, these are the columns. Then A, B, C, D, E, these are the rows. In this matrix, these are the columns, these are the rows. Clear, all of you? So how to generate this matrix? For example, A to A, is there any connection from A to A? Then there is no connection. Then there is no link. Then there is no edge. Simply here row A, then column A is 0. Then there is no connection. Clear, all of you? Then the next one, A to B is there. Then A to B is there, 1. If there is an edge, simply write 1. If there is no edge, simply write 0. Clear, all of you? If there is an edge or link between two nodes, write 1. If there is no link between two nodes, then that is write 0. Clear? Here. 1 is for it have an edge. 0 for it have not an edge. Clear? All of you. So simply here, first one is A row, and then the columns B, C, D, E. So A to A, no connection. Simply write 0. A to B, then there is a link. Simply write 1. Then A to C, yes, then there is a link between A to C. Write 1. Then A to D, then there is no link. So that is receiving. Then there is no outgoing link. This is incoming link. That's why we should write 0. Then the A to E, then there is no link, direct link. That's why we should write 0. Clear, all of you? So then the next node is B. So then B row. So B to A, 0. Then there is no link. Simply, this is directed graph. Clear? So then there is no outgoing link between A and B. Clear? Simply, B to A, 0. Next one is B to B. B to B is also 0. So next one, B to C, then there is no link. Then there's no direction. Then B to C is also 0. Then B to D, then there is a direction. Clear? Write 1. If it is a direction, arrow, then write 1. Then otherwise, outgoing directions. B to E, write 1. B to E, then there is a direction. Then write 1. Next, go to 0. Then C node. Take C node in this graph, all of you. Then C to A, no connection, no direction, 0. Then C to B, no direction, 0. Then C to C, no direction, 0. Then C to D, 1 direction, 1. Clear? Clear. C to D, 1 direction, 1. Next one, C to E, then there is no direction, direct direction. But simply write 0. Then go to D, all of you. Then D to A, so 1. D to A is there. D to A is the direction. Simply write 1. D to B, then there is no direction. Simply write 0. D to C is also, then there is no outgoing direction. Simply write 0. D to D itself is there. Write 1. Then write 1. D to E is also 1. Is there. Then write 1. Clear? Then go to the E row. So E row. E to A, 0. Then there is no direct direction. E to B, then there is no direct direction. E to C, then there is no direct direction. Then the next one, E to D, then there is no direct direction. E to E, no direct direction. Simply, in E row, all are zeros. Clear? In E row, all are zeros. This is the final output matrix. This matrix is called adjacency matrix. This matrix is called adjacency matrix. Clear, all of you? This is the most important. All of you write and explain graph representations are. What is graph representation? How many types of graph representations available? Write and explain adjacency matrix. Clear. This is simple, easy to get marks in your final examination. So you will get easily. Okay, ma. So in your final examinations. So then, for example, this is an example. So the how many nodes are there? 5 nodes. How many vertices? 5 vertices. Then your 5 columns and 5 rows. If the graph have 4 vertices, then 4x4 matrix. If the graph have 6 vertices, 6x6 matrix. If the graph have 3 vertices, 3x3 matrix. We will get 3x3 matrix. Clear, all of you? So simply this first. So the vertical and horizontal lines. The vertical lines. So these are the these represents columns. These represents rows. Clear, all of you? Horizontal, these are the horizontal, then these are represents columns. Vertical, these represents rows. Clear, all of you? This is the adjacency matrix. So directed graph representation. Clear? So this is, okay, all of you, this is undirected graph, then this is directed graph. So in the undirected graph, then there is no directed graph directions. So for all the edges are undirected. All the edges are undirected. That's why this is called fully undirected graph. Am I right? Undirected graph. It is not fully, but it is not complete, but it is a undirected graph. Clear? So whereas in undirected graph, here ABCD, how many rows? 5 rows. How many columns? 5 columns. 5 columns and 5 rows. Then A to A, no, 0. A to B, 1. So then the next one, A to C, 1. A to D, 1. Whereas in directed graph, A to D is 0. Because, so A to D, then there is no outgoing flow. Clear? That's why here 0. Whereas in the undirected graph, A to D is 0, then A to D is 1, D to A is also 1, your B to A is also 1, your C to A is also 1. Why? It is a bidirectional edges. It is a bidirectional edges. Then your data transfer from both edges, both vertices. Both vertices are both nodes. A is sending information, B is also sending information to A. A is sending information to B, and B is also sending information to A. So here both sides transactions are done here undirected graph. Clear, all of you? That's why. So then A to A is 0, A to B is 1, A to C is 1, A to D is 1, A to E is 0. Then there is no direct connection. That's why 0. Next one, B row. Come here, B row. B to A is 1, B to B is 0, B to C is 0, B to D is 1, B to E is 1. Come to the 0. B to A, C to A is 1, C to B is 0, C to D is 1, C to E is 0. Clear? Come to here. D to A is 1, D to B is 1, D to C is 1, D to E is 1, D to D is 1. Clear? Come to the E row. So E to E, E to A, 0. Then E to B, 1. E to C, 0. E to D, 1. E to E, 0. This is the adjacency matrix using undirected graph. We will get an adjacency matrix using undirected graph. This is adjacency matrix using directed graph. Clear, all of you? So these are the differences. Okay, this is one-way flow. But the previous is two-way flow. Clear, bidirectional flow. This is single flow. Clear, all of you? Then this is called the adjacency matrix. This is called adjacency matrix. Next matrix is incidence matrix. In this representation, the graph is represented using a matrix of size total number of vertices by a total number of edges. So in this representation, the graph is represented using a matrix of size total number of vertices by total number of edges. Total number of vertices. So total number of edges. How many vertices here? 5 edges. Here total number of edges, E1, E2, total 8 edges are there. So these are the edges. Edges are represented as columns, then vertices are represented in rows. Clear? Rows are vertices, then weights are edges. Clear? Total number of edges. That means graph with 4 vertices and 6 edges is represented using a matrix of size 4x6. 4 by 6. In this matrix, rows represent vertices and column represents edges. Clear? Columns represents edges. Clear, all of you? Edges. This matrix is filled with 0 or 1 or minus 1. Here 0 represents the row edge is not connected to column vertex. 1 represents that the row edge is connected as the outgoing edge to column vertex, and minus 1 represents the row edge is connected as the incoming edge to column vertex. All of you. So simply, this is the row A, then E1. So this is A, E1 is connected, yes or no? So simply it is standing, then the value is 1. Then the next one is row A, then it is connected to C, the edge is E2, that is 1. Then the A, E3, but it is not sending. That's why we should write minus 1. Clear? It is receiving, not sending. That's why we should write minus 1. Then E2A, then there is no incoming edge and outgoing edge. Simply write 0. So E2D. Then there is no incoming and outgoing. Simply write 0. E4, which is the E4? This one, edge 4. Edge 4, 0. Then the next one, edge 5, 0. Next one, edge 6, 0. Edge 7 is also 0. All of you, I repeat this. So first take A row, then edge 1 is connected, yes. If it is connected, then write 1. Then edge 2 is connected, yes. Then write 1. Next one is E3. E3 is connected, but it is incoming. We should write minus 1. So then the E4, then there is no outgoing and incoming edge. Simply, it is not related to A. That's why we should write 0. Then E5, it is not connected. It is not a relation between A and E5. Simply, that should write 0. Next one, E6, it is also not connected. Then E6, E7, that is also not connected. Then E8, that is also not connected. Then write 0s. Next one, take B row. B2A, so then B is receiving, but not sending. So E1 is minus 1. Clear? Then E2, then 0. B2, E3, 0. Then there is no incoming and outgoing. But that's why we should write 0. B2, E4, yes, that is 1. Yes, B2, E4, simply sending. Yes or no? This is outgoing edge is there. E4 is an outgoing edge. That's why we should write 1. Clear? So if it is an incoming edge, we should write minus 1. If it is an outgoing edge, we should write 1. Then there is no edge, simply write 0. Clear? Then E5, it is not an edge of B. That's why we should write 0. E5 is 0. Then the next one, B2, E6. So it is an outgoing edge. So we should write in 1. Then the next one, B2, E7. Then there is no edge, write 0. B2, E8, that is also 0. Clear, all of you? Next one, C. C2A. So minus 1. C2E1 is 0. Then there is no direction. C2E2 is an incoming edge. That's why you should write minus 1. So then C2E3, 0. C2E4, 0. C2E5, 1. No, C2E5 is 1. Why? This is an outgoing edge. Clear? C2E5 is 1. So next one, C2E6, 0. C2E7, 0. C2E8 is also 0. Next one, coming to the D row. D2A, this is an outgoing, D2E1, so 0. D2E2, 0. D2E3, it is an outgoing, 1. Yes, D2E4, this is an incoming, minus 1. D2E5, it is also incoming, minus 1. D2E6, so 0. D2E7 is outgoing, minus 1. D2E7 is outgoing, that's why we should write 1. So D2E8, so D8, incoming, then write 1. D2E8 is 1, okay? Clear, all of you? Then the next one is coming to the E. All are zeros and two ones. So E6 and E7 minus ones, remaining are zeros. Why E6 and E7 minus ones? So these are the incoming edges. If it is an incoming edge, then we should write minus one. If it is an outgoing edge, we should write one. Then there is no relation. Okay, simply write zero. Clear? Then there are two incoming edges. Those two are the minus one, minus one. E6 is minus one and E7 is minus one. And the remaining are zeros. Clear? This type of matrix are called incidence matrix. Incidence matrix. Next one is adjacency list. Adjacency list. Okay, all of you. So then there are three types of representations. The first one is adjacency matrix. Second one is incidence matrix. Most important. Okay. So all of you. Third one is adjacency list. We need to discuss adjacency list. What is adjacency list? In this representation, every vertex of a graph contains list of its adjacent vertices. List of its adjacent vertices. For example, consider the following directed graph representation implementing using linked list. For example, consider the following directed graph representation implemented using linked list. Here, then how many edges are there? How many vertices are there? Nodes? Total 5 nodes. Here, A, B, C, D. Clear. A, B, C, D, E. 5 edges. Then, what are the adjacent list of A? A to B and B to E. Clear? A to B and A to C. These two are the adjacents. A to B, A to C. So, simply write this. A to B and C. Clear? So, these are the adjacents of A. A, B, C. These are the adjacents of A. Next one is B adjacents. What are the adjacents of B? B, D, B, D, and E. These two are the adjacents of B. Clear? B, D, and B, E. If, why? A is not an adjacent of B because it is a directed graph. It is an undirected graph. A is also an adjacent of B. Clear? So, because it is an undirected graph, if it is an undirected graph, A is also an adjacent of B. But it is a directed graph. That's why it is not adjacent of A. Clear? Then B, what are the adjacents of B? D and E. So, these are the adjacents of B. Next one, adjacents of C. What are the adjacents of C? C, D. Only D is an adjacent of C. Clear? Next one, what are the adjacents of D? So, A. Clear? Then itself D and E. These three are the, D is also adjacent of D because self loop is there. Self loop is there. Then it can send the value and also receive the same value. So it is executing itself again and again. Clear? That is called self-function call. Self-function call. Whereas in C language, that is called recursive function call. Clear? So that's why D is also adjacent of D. Here, simply, what are the adjacents of D? D, A, D, E. Clear? A, D, E. Clear, all of you. These are the adjacents of D. Then the adjacents of E, then there is no outgoing edge of E. This is a final edge. Okay, final edge. Only one edge is. Then there is no adjacents. Okay, this type of representation is called adjacency list. This type of representation is called adjacency list. Clear? This representation also can implement using an array as follows. That is linked list representation. This is linked list representation. Then the next one, this is an array representation. Here A, here 0, 1, 2, 4. How many vertex are there? 5 vertices. Then total 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Lower bound value 0, upper bound value 0, and minus 1. 5 minus 1 equal to 4. Clear? Here A, B, C, D, E. Then there is no adjacents. That's why A stop this. Here A, how many? B and C. These two are the adjacents of A. Adjacency list. What are the adjacents of B? D and E. These two are the adjacents of B. Then what are the adjacents of C? So only D is an adjacent of adjacency of C. So what are the adjacents of D? So A, D and E. A, D, E. Okay. Then E, null. Clear. These are the adjacency list. Using linked list representation, using array representation. Using linked list representation, this is the linked list representation. This is the array representation. Each node have how many parts? Two parts. One is for edge, another one is for link, that is connected to the next node. So here also next node. Then there is no edge simply. Then there is no, so edge simply null value assigned into this location. Clear? These are all the null final. Clear? Then this is linked list representation. This is an array representation. All of you. Tomorrow we will discuss graph traversal algorithms. The most important traversal algorithms. There are two types of graph traversal algorithms. The first one is DFS and the second one is BFS. So we know tree traversal algorithms. What are the tree traversal algorithms? In-order tree traversal algorithm, pre-order tree traversal algorithm, and post-order tree traversal algorithm. In-order, pre-order, and post-order. Three types of tree traversals. In the graphs, graphs also having traversal algorithms. There are two types of traversal algorithms. The first one is DFS algorithm. Second one is BFS algorithm. Depth first search and breadth first search. These two are the most important. Okay, ma. Never. They will ask, write and explain DFS algorithm or write and explain BFS algorithm in final examination. So tomorrow we will discuss DFS and BFS algorithms. Clear, all of you? Okay, ma. Bye.